Welcome to TFNN.
Hi, thank you for having me.
Absolutely. So tell us a little bit about Forward Pedalis and how you work with, you know, the individual governments that are out here inside of Pinellas County and exactly what the goals of Forward Pinellas are.
Well, I think you covered it really nicely. Forward Pinellas is a planning council. We do land use and transportation planning. We have a board of elected officials that make our decisions on guiding us ahead. We have a set of different areas that we focus on, and we try our best to integrate land use and transportation since we know they're so integrated together. And we have a lot of discussions with our local governments, our other partners like the Florida Department of Transportation and the Pinellas Suncoast Transit Authority to make sure we're all moving in the same direction.
Now, when we start talking about transportation, you know, Florida is lagging in transportation in a monster way. I know that you know, when we're talking about the PSTA in St. Petersburg, the Sunrunner, that's a big deal. You know, the bottom line is that somehow you got that through. I don't know if you are basically people working got a transportation bill through. So the bottom line, you know, pedestrians in general. I mean, we see it a lot here because we had a couple roads, folks, that are very dangerous. Like one is US 19, and for some reason, people just walk across them. What is the, you know, I know when I go through your website, okay, you're always looking to protect pedestrians and you're always looking to basically protect people. What is the problem with people just walking across major highways?
That's a really tough question. So one of the things we find is that there aren't a lot of spaces on some of these places like US 19 for people to cross. And so sometimes people do just walk across because it's so far for them to get to a place where they can safely cross and
yes,
then walk back to where they're going. So some of it's a design, and it is very dangerous. We have, on average, two people killed or injured, seriously injured, every day on our roadways.
Yeah, pretty amazing. Yeah.
Pedestrians, bicyclists, motorcyclists, people in cars, it's a lot of people.
Yes. So let's switch gears a bit here, and let's go to the bicycle riders, because now what has happened, of course, across Pinellas County, well, across the United States, no doubt, people love bicycles. We get bicycle lanes, and then what's happening also is that you actually have bicycles in the street, which is a bicycle lane. So how is that aspect going as we move forward?
We're always looking for different ways. It is, bicyclists are allowed to be in the lane, and then we do have the facilities for them that are separated, and we're always looking at ways that we can make it safer for people biking. And sometimes those accommodations are a little different than someone who's walking and using the sidewalk. So we're looking at buffered bike lanes. Actually, we're doing a test soon with the City of St. Petersburg at a protected intersection to provide a little bit more safety when people are biking. It'll be on 1st Avenue South and 2nd Street in downtown St. Pete, and that should be coming soon.
Okay, in a protected intersection, what does that mean?
It means that the bicyclist is a little more separated from the cars, and it's less space where they're crossing. It gives them a little more visibility. It also gives the pedestrian a little more visibility, and it makes the crossing safer.
Nice. Now, how do you get to people? You know, what is intriguing, like, let's say a couple years ago, and in St. Pete, folks, okay, we have a huge amount of bicycles. We have a huge amount of scooters. I mean, the bottom line is it's a walkable city. It's a great city for that. And you have to be very attuned in your own car because of that fact. So when we actually, you know, went to that, we can put them on the road, how much do you find that, you know, how do you educate the drivers that, hey, listen, man, you know, the bicycles can be on the road with us drivers simultaneously?
We can never do enough education. That's something we're always looking for ideas. It's conversations like this one where we can talk about it and just reach a different group of people, a different audience who might not have heard of us and what we're trying to do before. We do printed materials. We post things on social media, on Facebook. So we're always looking for different ways, working especially with partners and others who might be able to help us share information about safety with people.
Nice. And what do you find is your biggest challenge right now? You know, we have the breakout going on. You know, hopefully the worst of COVID's behind us. What is your biggest challenge right now at Forward Pinellas?
I would say our biggest challenge is always that we want to have more projects, more transportation projects. We want to keep things moving. We want things to move quickly. And sometimes they just take a lot of money and a lot of time. And so it's balancing the two of getting things done, but also realizing that they take time and money to happen.
And patience. And it sounds like that you have some patience, too. Well, listen, we appreciate all the work you do. You know, we love the idea of a walkable city, a bikeable city, a safe city. And you guys are at the forward, I guess that's why it's Forward Pinellas, of all of that, which is really great. Sarah, you have a great one, safe one. We look forward to having you on again.
Great. Thank you.